this GIMP workshop, we're going to change a color photo into a digital painting. We'll use the smudge tool and several other techniques. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. When we've opened our image in GIMP, we can click on the zoom icon in the top right to make the image fit in the window. Double-click on the name and rename it Original. Hit Enter. Click on the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel to make a duplicate. Double-click on the name and rename it Sharpness. Hit Enter. Place the cursor more or less in the center of the image. Press and hold the Control key and zoom in a bit by rolling the mouse wheel away from you. Now we go to the menu bar, click on Filters and on Enhance, and then on Unsharp Mask. Make the standard deviation 1.4. When we click the preview off and on, we can see the difference. We have to keep in mind, however, that we might need to adjust the given values in this video when we use an image of our own with a different size or different characteristics. Now click OK. We make another duplicate by clicking on the Duplicate button again. We name this one Blur. Hit Enter. Back to Filters, and now to Blur, and then Selective Gaussian Blur. This blurs only the areas with low contrast, so most of the sharpness stays intact. Make the blur radius 12. Click on the Split View option. We can click and drag the line to the left or to the right. When we press and hold the Control key and then click on the line, the split view changes from vertical to horizontal. Now click OK. Duplicate the layer again and name it Symmetric. Again to Filters and Enhance. Now we click on Symmetric Nearest Neighbor. Here we can make the radius 15, so we already get a bit of the painting effect. Click the preview off and on. We can also zoom in or out a bit. And when you feel it's OK, you hit the OK button. Go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Again, a new duplicate. And this one we name Smudge. In the toolbox we activate the Smudge tool. Make the opacity about 40. We start with brush hardness 0.25 and we make the size about 35. Zoom in to one of the eyes. We have to pay attention to the direction of our brush strokes. They give a different effect when we stroke from a dark to a light area, or vice versa. We can also move the brush back and forth, or we can make circles. With Ctrl Z we can undo one or more previous made steps. When we press and hold the left or right bracket key, we can change the brush size. And when we hold the spacebar down, the brush changes into the Move tool and we can move the image by moving the mouse without clicking. For the sake of the tutorial, we'll now go fast forward. When we want to smudge the hair, we can choose brush bristles too. Then we can make the force as well as the rate about 75. In this way we get longer and stronger strokes. Make sure to follow the flow of the hair and again we go fast forward. Feel it's enough, we go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Now we will work with the Dutch Burn tool. Click on the New Layer button. Name it Dutch Burn. Change the mode to Overlay. Make sure that the fill type is Transparency. Click OK. Then we click on the foreground button of the foreground background colors. Fill in the HTML notation 80, 80, and again 80. This gives us a medium gray. Click OK. Drag and drop this gray from the foreground background colors into the image. In the layers panel we can see that it's gray now, but because of the overlay mode it's not visible in the image. Activate the Dutch Burn tool. First we click on the Reset button at the bottom of the tool options. In this way we reset the tool options to its default. Check the option Highlights. Make the opacity about 10. Choose Brush Hardness 0.25. We will start with a size of about 150. Now we can carefully lighten up certain areas. Here too, we can use Ctrl-Z to undo, and fast forward we go. When we are finished with the lighter areas, we go back to the tool options. Now check the option Burn to make certain areas a bit darker. Click also on the option Shadows. And again we go fast forward a bit. When this is to our liking, we go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window again. Click the Dutch Burn layer off and on to see the difference. Now we will add a vignette. Click on the New Layer button. Name it Vignette. Make the mode Normal. And the fill should still be Transparency. Click OK. Then we go to Filters. Light and Shadow, and hit Vignette. Click on Color. Make the color white by dragging the cross in the preview pane to the top left. Then click OK. Make the radius 1.7 and the softness 0.5. And then we click OK. Now to finish off we will add some highlights. Activate the smudge layer. Go to the toolbox and click on the paintbrush. Click on the bent arrow of the foreground background colors. We now have white as our foreground color. Make the opacity about 20. We still have brush hardness 0.25. Make the size 6. Zoom in very far to one of the eyes. There are already highlights, we just have to make them a bit brighter. Then we can do the same with the other eye. Now move down to the mouth and make a little highlight on the lower lip, like so. When we feel that it looks okay, we go to View again, click on Zoom, and then on Fit Image in Window. Press and hold the Shift key and then click on the eye of the bottom layer to see the difference between the original and the edited image. I hope that you have fun with this game workshop. Please give it a thumbs up and a nice comment is of course also much appreciated. Thank you very much for watching.